You can go upstairs, downstairs. Doesn't make a difference if they're carpeted, if they're concrete steps, if they're metal steps, anything of that nature. It allows officers to be in a position and to actually see what's going on without putting themselves in harm's way. We can use it inside a residence, outside a residence. For example, if we wanted to, if there's a suspicious item underneath a vehicle, we can utilize the camera and the claw camera to look under the vehicle.
Sure.
All of those things. So. We're outside around the corner here already. I'm coming back in. There's multiple cameras. There's different drive cameras for forward, for reverse. There's a claw camera right up there for grabbing. We can open up lever doors, turn knob doors, any of those things. It was really an invaluable tool because we were able to get into the apartment where Randall was barricaded and actually do a visual inspection of that apartment without putting any officers at risk. And
Or the suspect too, right? I mean.
well, right, because now we don't have six or seven tactical officers in there. Not to say we would force a confrontation, but that it would force him, his hand.
Yep.
And then because of our own safety, we'd have to take appropriate action.
Yep.
So, in this case, the way this robot was used in that specific situation, you're aware there was an explosive breach at the front door. The door was barricaded, and so we removed that obstacle from the element. So the door was taken off the hinges and pushed in, and we removed the barricade partially that was there. And then we used the robot to remove the doorway all the way from the threshold. So then we had a clear avenue inside. Then we operated in there. We were able to clear the living room, the dining room, the kitchen, went into the bedroom. I was able then to utilize the articulating arm here, and I brought that up. Then we utilized our camera. We were able to articulate that around to see inside of that residence. Then I was able to see Mr. Randall behind the bedroom door. You could see him laying down there. Then the communication started. So the Cross County Sheriff's Department here under arrest. So we were able to communicate with him, told him to show us his hands. He complied with all that. We continued to talk with him. You can also hear audio with this as well.
Sure.
And he listened to our commands, and then we followed him right back out of the residence, following him with the robot. Legs get extended in different formations for either going up or down the stairs. When I removed the door, I had the leg down so it adds more stability.
Sure.
More gripping power. We can use night vision cameras, or we can use just regular lights on like that to illuminate. So it's got a little bit of everything.